Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ayush Mittal and today we will learn about anaerobic digester, or we can say anaerobic tank reactor. So before going to the working of the anaerobic digester, let us understand about its components. So here we have basically two units. This is our main working unit and here we have our control unit. This control unit controls the working of this unit. So let us understand about the components of this working unit. So as you can see here we have our column 1, and when this water reaches up to this height in column, then from here the outlet of the water comes and through this pipe it will reach in this column. This is called as intermediate column, and as you can see here this pipe sucks the water from this column and it will fill this column. This column is known as second column. So and the other three parts of this component are at behind. So this is our gas collector tank 1. This collects the gas in this column, and this is our gas collector tank 2. It collects the gas in this column, and one column remaining in this, that is we have our water bath inside this. So our one column remaining in this part is the water bath, that is stated inside this part. And after that we will know about these pumps. This is our primary pump, which flows the water, raw water, from this can to our column 1. This is our primary pump, and here as you can see this is our secondary pump. It is responsible for the flow of water from intermediate column to the column 1. So now let's move ahead to the next unit of our anaerobic digester. So as you can see, this is our control unit of anaerobic digester, which controls our working unit. As you can see here, we have our 15-inch TFT display through which we can control the working unit. So let's wait until it on. Here we have our main switch and here is the LED indicator for it. So as you can see on the screen, this tab is for line diagram. This line diagram is the connections of pipes and columns in our working unit. And for experimentation tab, we have here our whole control unit. So this is the switch for primary pump. Here we have switch for secondary pump to on. And from this we can control our flow rate of our primary pump. Let's say we can enter it 300, and for our secondary pump we can set it at 150. And this control unit is for column 1 and this control unit is for column 2. Here we have our diagram and image of our working unit. So as you can see, in column 1 we have our set value temperature and current value temperature in degree Celsius. So we can set temperature value, for example let us set it at 45 degree Celsius, and current value of temperature, you can see it is 29.1. and liquid out temperature, we can also measure liquid out temperature of column 1 and pH value of column 1. And here we have our temperature measurement of intermediate tank. And for column 2, as you can see here, we also have set value temperature from which we will set it at 45 degree Celsius. And as you can see, the current value of our temperature is 29.4 degree Celsius. And we can also measure liquid out temperature and pH value of column 2. Here you can see we have our water bath temperature measurement. We can set value of temperature of water bath, let us say we can also set it at 45 degree Celsius, and as you can see current value of temperature of water bath is 28.4 degree Celsius. Here we have our heater switches, three heater switches for column 1, column 2 and water bath. So now let's move ahead to the working of the anaerobic digester. So first of all, we will fill our column 1 with water. So as you can see here, our raw water tank is connected and this pipe is connected to the primary pump. So let's on the switch of the primary pump. So as you can see, the primary pump started filling the column 1. So let's wait until it fills the column up to a height. So now as we can notice here, our limit of water has reached to this valve. So we will have to open this valve. We will have to keep close this valve so that the water moves through this pipe and it will fill the intermediate tank. Before that, we will have to make sure that this valve is closed, so that when the gas is generating in this, it will not go out from this So let's wait until it fills the intermediate tank up to a height so that it submerges to this pipe. So now, as you can see here, the intermediate tank is filled to a limit. So now we will start our secondary pump so that our column 2 starts filling up. Before that, make sure that this valve is closed so that if any kind of heat is any kind of gas is maintained in this tank, it will not leak out from this valve. Okay, so now let's on our pump 2. As we can see here, our column 1, column 2 and intermediate tank has filled with water to the limits. And while filling with water, make sure that this pressure and temperature, pH and temperature measurement knob is submerged into the water in all the three columns. Because if this is not submerged in water, then our measurement of pH and temperature in control unit is not accurate. After that, we will fill our gas tank 1 as well as gas tank 2 with water so that when we heat our column 1 and column 2, then the gas generated in this part is while moving, this gas moves in column 1 and column 2 can be measured from the volume here. So now let's on the heater so that the gas generates in column 1 and column 2 while we are filling our gas tank 1 and gas tank 2 with water. So now we will fill our gas tank 1 and gas tank 2 with water. So while filling gas tank 1 and gas tank 2 with water, make sure that this valve is open for air to pass into the tank, and this valve is open so that we can put water into this column. And similarly, we will open both the valves in gas tank 2 also so that the air can pass while we fill water in both the tanks. So now let's fill the water through the funnel. As we can see here, our column 1 set value temperature is 45 degrees Celsius and current value temperature has also reached 45 degrees Celsius as our heater is on. Similarly, in column 2 also we can see here our set value and current value temperature both are 45 degrees Celsius and heater is on. So now we will on our gas valve so that the gas from column 1 and column 2 reaches gas collecting tank tank 1 and gas collecting tank 2 respectively. So now we will open our gas valve so that gas is collected in this. Before that, make sure both the valves of upper funnel as well as air valve are closed so that air cannot pass from above column. So, and we will also take measurement of the level of water filled here. So as I can notice here, the level of water here is 27. So now I will open the gas valve coming from column 1 so that the gas can pass in this column. So let's open this valve. As we can see here, the volume of the gas has filled in this gas collecting valve. So to mark the readings of this, we will make our first reading was when 27, when water was full, and when after the gas come here, our reading was 18.5. Similarly, for the second column, we will measure the readings from the gas collecting tank 2. So as I can see here, the gas collecting 2 and gas collecting tank 1, the temperature in both the column 1 and column 2 are same. So the volume of both the columns is also same. That's all for now about the anaerobic digester. And if you guys have any doubt regarding anaerobic digester, you can go through the website Tesca Global. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and do subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to share it with your friends. Thank you.